This is the new Vauxhall Zafira.
Unlike some family cars, it doesn't just have 5 seats, it has 7.
And yet, there's still more head and leg room than with some big cars.
Thanks to Flex 7 technology, you can remove the seats without actually removing them, like this, and like this. So, here we have 1,700 litres of space. That's much, much more than in some estate cars. Of course, being bigger on the inside, on the outside, it has to be that little bit bigger than some big cars. And this one is, well, no, that can't be right, though, can it? Well, because it's smaller. It's a lot smaller. No, I don't understand.
Vauxhall, raising the standard.
Kodak Advantix cameras, a great way to take pictures and share pictures. From only $39.99.
After the break, the mass sea rescue in the Channel, the plane crash in America, the latest pictures on both. Join me then.
Imagine your holiday destination of a lifetime. Now imagine in this place something has happened that will shatter your illusions. Nightmare in a place where dreams are made. Tonight with Trevor MacDonald, Thursday at 10 on ITV.
Stuart Thelan, a doctor tormented by the system. Stuart Thelan, a man tormented by his past. Monday at 9, ITV.
If you need a sensitive new age man,
are you still here?
Then you better look somewhere else.
They are banged to rights.
A case to test Frost's patience.
Being good is not enough anymore. Even you are going to have to work with the system eventually.
A case to test Frost's instincts.
She was lured here and murdered.
I'm going to come knock, knock, knocking at your door. Hope you can sleep at night.
A Touch of Frost, Deep Waters, Thursday at 8 on ITV.
It might all end in tears.
Yeah, hello? Yeah, I'm in a bit of a rush, mate. No, no, it's okay, I can talk. What's the matter? Yeah, hello? Yeah, I'm in a bit of a rush, mate. No, no, it's okay, I can talk. What's the matter?
BT Cellnet brings you new ways of communicating, like our one phone, the only home phone that's also a mobile. You never know, it might change your life. BT Cellnet, good call.
Carry the big fresh flavor wherever you go.
Wrigley's has always had the biggest, freshest flavor.
The big fresh flavor.
Daddy's in trouble with the Inland Revenue. Not paying his taxes.
Mummy, do animals get married?
Robinson's fruit and barley.
Is the sea there because somebody left the tap on?
Feed their imagination.
Impact protection system. Try the Citroen Saxo from only $6,995 with 2 years free insurance.
And that's not all. Sound deadening.
And an acoustically engineered floor to reduce engine noise. The Citroen Saxo, available from just $6,995 with 2 years free insurance.
Hello?
Perché você não fez a pra tomar o último filho?
Ah, que bom!
Então você pode me ajudar com esse muro?
He who drinks Australian, thinks Australian.
It's very easy to prevent the build-up of limescale. Simply use one Calgon tablet at the beginning of every wash.
Washing machines live longer with Calgon.
At 11:30 here on Carlton, a student finds himself on the wrong side of the law in our late film, Run.
Could there be a breakthrough? More peace talks tomorrow. 150 saved in dramatic sailing rescue. 9 dead, scores injured in American plane crash. And is he Schmeichel Mark II? Bosnić goes to United.
From ITN, the ITV Nightly News with Katie Derrick.
Good evening. Hopes of an end to the Kosovo war were still alive tonight after a first meeting in Belgrade between President Milosevic and the EU and Russian envoys. The Yugoslav side said it wanted to think about the terms they presented and talk again tomorrow. The Russian envoy Viktor Chernomyrdin said tonight it was a difficult choice for the Yugoslav leadership, but the choice had to be made. Here's our foreign news correspondent, Paul Davis.
The envoys delivered NATO's terms for peace in a meeting that lasted 1.5 hours this evening. Slobodan Milosevic and his political and military advisers gathered in the presidential palace in a suburb of Belgrade to hear the conditions under which the NATO bombing would be halted.
And I think it was very important.
The Finnish president, Martti Ahtisaari, explaining he'd not come to negotiate, but to set out NATO's terms. President Milosevic now wants time to study and question the offer. The talks will continue in the morning. It's also understood the Serbian Assembly will discuss the plan tomorrow. Earlier, the arrival of the Finnish president and the Russian envoy Viktor Chernomyrdin in Belgrade had been delayed for several hours while Russia and the NATO allies argued about the terms that would be put to the Serbian president. Russia wants to see two separate forces, one Russian, one NATO-led, sent to Kosovo to oversee the return of the refugees. NATO insists there should be one force only, with one command structure. Despite this substantial difference of policy, Mr. Ahtisaari still sounded confident on his arrival.
This is a historic day for Yugoslavia.
Это исторический день для Югославии.
Mr. Chernomyrdin and I are coming with a peace plan.
President Clinton tonight warned Serbia of the cost of rejecting the offer that's now on the table.
There is a clear choice before the Serbian leader. He can cut his losses now and accept the basic requirements of a just peace, or he can continue to force military failure and economic ruin on his people.
Despite the pressure on President Milosevic, diplomats here at the Foreign Office do not expect to see his signature on a peace settlement, not at this stage anyway. At best, they hope after talks tomorrow, Mr. Ahtisaari can leave Belgrade with the basis of a future settlement. And the Foreign Secretary is again warning President Milosevic this is not the time to try to fool the international community. Paul Davis, ITN, at the Foreign Office.
Tonight, the Prime Minister, who's in Cologne for the EU summit tomorrow, spoke to our diplomatic editor, Robert Moore. He said President Milosevic still had to accept all NATO's demands.
Let us hope that we're going to get this done in the right way. But let's be clear what the right way is. The right way is that NATO's demands, which have been very clear throughout, as I say, the troops and paramilitaries in Milosevic go out, the international force goes in, the refugees go back. Those demands have to be met. And it's not simply a question of what we agree with the Russians, it's that Milosevic himself has to accept these demands. And in the meantime, our strategy has to continue.
The Kosovo conflict spilled over into football today when UEFA refused to call off the Euro 2000 qualifier between the Republic of Ireland and Yugoslavia on Saturday. The Irish government then refused to issue visas for the Yugoslav players. So, as Terry Lloyd reports, the game is off.
as sport clashed with politics, the Irish Taoiseach hinted that he would bar the Yugoslav team from Dublin.
It is not for the government to force a sporting decision on a body until the body makes that decision. If it refuses, then we have a decision to make.
Ireland's players who trained for a match they didn't want were told the Irish FA was on their side.
There is a war going on, and we felt that although we didn't want to get into the political situation, equally we didn't want to be used as pawns in a political strategy.
The team may now be penalised by UEFA, who insisted the game should go ahead, even though Ireland's Euro 2000 group included Yugoslavia, Macedonia and Croatia. Politicians and players felt they were in a no-win situation. Tonight, the Irish government said they would not be used for propaganda purposes as the situation in Kosovo deteriorates. Terry Lloyd, ITN, Dublin.
A massive rescue operation was mounted this evening after 77 boats competing in a national yachting regatta off Weymouth in Dorset were capsized by a squall. 154 people were thrown into the sea, but all are safe. Helen Wright has the full story.
Rescued and under tow for shore, one of the 77 catamarans that capsized when a freak squall hit competitors in sailing championships off the Dorset coast. With 154 sailors thrown into the sea, the emergency services feared the worst and raced to the scene. The Coast Guard helicopter, lifeboats and private boats all responded to a mayday call and rushed to Weymouth Bay to help. Tonight, all the competitors are back on dry land. Only one is in hospital.
It was just shock, you know, just out of nowhere, because it's the worst I've ever been in, you know, so we're lucky to survive.
All the catamarans have also been recovered and are now being repaired, ready for more racing tomorrow. Organisers say today they were just caught out by freak weather.
Halfway through the race, the wind got up much earlier than the forecast had suggested, and got up to maybe 4-8, and which made life very, very difficult.
All the men and women involved in these races are highly experienced sailors, but despite that expertise, each must tonight consider themselves lucky that the vast majority of their number escaped this incident unscathed. Helen Wright, ITN, Weymouth. Local authorities got an official food hazard warning from the government tonight about Belgian chickens and eggs, which could be contaminated with the cancer-causing chemical dioxin. Some chicken products have already been withdrawn from supermarket shelves in what could become the biggest food scare since the beef ban. The socialist group in the European Parliament called today for a ban on Belgian chocolate, though at least one major manufacturer has denied using any eggs. The dioxin apparently got into chicken feed used at more than 400 farms. Up to 9 people were reported killed today when an American Airlines Super 80 airliner crashed as it landed in a thunderstorm at Little Rock, Arkansas. The plane skidded on the runway, broke up and burst into flames. John Irvine reports.
The plane careered off the runway at Little Rock and burst into flames. It broke up into 3 pieces, but incredibly, most of those on board were able to escape with their lives. From the wreckage, some of the passengers had to wade through water. The jet had come to rest beside a river. The weather in Arkansas today was fine, but the conditions last night were very different and probably caused the crash. A violent thunderstorm brought high winds and torrential rain. As the jet touched down, it skidded out of control. For those who'd come to meet the 145 people on board, there was an anxious wait. But eventually, for most, there was an emotional reunion. For some, however, there was no relief or joy. 9 people died in the crash, including the pilot. John Irvine, ITN, in the United States.
South Africa's second democratic election, the one to decide on Nelson Mandela's successor, passed without any bloodshed or intimidation today. All the signs are that President Mandela will bequeath another landslide ANC win to Thabo Mbeki, but some serious problems too. Our Africa correspondent Tim Hewitt reports.
As darkness fell in the Johannesburg township of Alexandra, thousands of people were still waiting to vote. Many had queued for 12 hours.
I'm sick of this. They better do something better.
Nelson Mandela waited a lifetime for democracy. At the age of 80, he was voting for just the second time. Thabo Mbeki will take over the presidency. His ANC party is heading for an overwhelming majority. But he's under pressure to deliver on reforms. In the townships, voters want more rapid change in the post-apartheid era.
We don't have water facilities. We don't have anything, you know. So crime is worse.
Most whites now support opposition parties, expected to get less than a fifth of the vote. As the first ballot boxes were emptied and the count began, the election was still going on. People queuing in the dark were assured that polling stations wouldn't close until they'd been able to cast their vote. The first results tonight, reflecting just a tiny proportion of the votes cast, give the ANC nearly 60%. Their target is two-thirds, allowing them to change some parts of the constitution. They'll know tomorrow if they've achieved it. Tim Ewart, ITN, Johannesburg.
A survey of car owners due out in the morning will reveal what they think of their cars. Some of the biggest motor manufacturers don't fare well in the Consumers Association research, though dealers say all new cars are reliable. Owners were asked if they would recommend their make to a friend. Subaru came top with 90% saying they would. Skoda also did well, getting 83%, and Jaguar got 82%. Others, though, were less successful. Of Ford owners, 53% surveyed said they'd recommend their car. For Vauxhall, it was 50%, and Rover got 47%. The Sun newspaper was told by the Press Complaints Commission today that it made a grave and reprehensible error with its picture of a topless Sophie Rees-Jones. It's tonight publishing a second apology. Nicholas Owen reports.
A fortnight to her wedding, Sophie Rees-Jones today hoping that the topless picture fiasco will now fade away. Under its chairman, Lord Wakeham, the Press Complaints Commission this afternoon considered a Buckingham Palace complaint that The Sun invaded Miss Rees-Jones' privacy by printing a photograph taken 11 years ago. The paper did apologise next day and makes a new apology in tomorrow's issue after strong criticism that it broke the press code of practice.
The newspaper's apology in no way excuses the grave error which was made, nor lessens the distress which it caused Miss Rees-Jones. The decision to publish these pictures was reprehensible, and that such a mistake must not happen again.
Buckingham Palace officials echo that. They are also anxious not to prolong the arguments as the wedding approaches. The publication of the topless picture and the original jocular apology infuriated the royal family. Tonight, Buckingham Palace said it was satisfied that the issues raised by its complaint have now been resolved. Nicholas Owen, ITN, at the Press Complaints Commission.
The supermarket giant Sainsbury's announced 1,100 management redundancies today. The company said its annual profit figure, up just 3%, was unacceptable, and the job losses would save it £160 million over the next 3 years. In recent years, Tesco has overtaken Sainsbury's to become Britain's most profitable supermarket chain. And the Coronation Street star Johnny Briggs was today banned for 14 months and fined £1,400 for drink driving. Briggs, who plays Mike Baldwin, was said to have drunk more than twice the legal limit when he was stopped in his Mercedes convertible on the M6. Aston Villa's Australian goalkeeper Mark Bosnich today signed for Manchester United, where he started his British career 10 years ago. Bosnich appeared at a photo call at his new club after agreeing a four-year contract thought to be worth £1 million a year. He paid tributes to Peter Schmeichel, who he'll replace at Old Trafford, and later said he'd be a tough act to follow.
That was the main bait for me. That was the main challenge to come here, to see whether or not I could fill his shoes. It's going to be a huge task, there's no doubt about that.
Two winning tickets shared the £3.8 million jackpot in tonight's National Lottery draw. The winning numbers were 17, 23, 27, 34, 36 and 37. The bonus ball was 12. The main news again, Yugoslavia is expected to give an answer tomorrow to terms presented today for ending the Kosovo War. Tonight's financial figures, the euro hit another new low against the pound today, closing at just over 64 pence, down 0.6 of a penny. The FTSE 100 index was up 52 points, and on Wall Street, the Dow Jones Industrial Average closed tonight down 18 points. Now for a look at tomorrow's newspapers. Make or break day for peace is the Independent's lead story on the Kosovo talks, above a picture of refugees' tents in Albania. The Times' main picture is also of a refugee. It says Russia and the West have overcome a last-minute clash to produce a peace deal. Envoys put peace offer to Milosevic is the Telegraph's version. It says a breakthrough's been made on a blueprint for peace. Blair's blast at grammar schools is the Daily Mail's lead. It says the Prime Minister has ruled out a return to selective schools because they leave too many scars. The Express headline is Fast Food Poison Alert and reports that Kentucky Fried Chicken has halted the import of contaminated poultry from Belgium. And the Mirror revels in its main rival's apology over those Sophie Rees-Jones pictures, saying the Sun has been dumped in the gutter. That's it from ITV's Nightly News. I'll be back at the same time tomorrow. Until then, good night.
Good evening. Flaming June continues. More showers to come, and by the weekend it's going to turn much cooler as well. Plenty of rain around at the moment, especially in the north of the country. And during the next few hours, it'll slip further across Scotland. A drier interlude before more rain splashes along southern coastal areas during tomorrow, then eventually most places settling into sunshine and showers. But rather more than showers around just now, especially, as I say, in the northern half of the country, some heavy and persistent rain here, still the odd rumble of thunder. If it's any consolation, it's not going to be a cold night. Temperatures around 10 Celsius, 50 Fahrenheit. Later on in the night, more rain spreading into the far southwest, and that'll continue along many southern areas during the course of tomorrow. So a wet start here, and a wet start across many parts of Scotland, Northern Ireland, northernmost counties of England. But a drier zone in between, and hopefully during the course of the afternoon, that dry zone should expand. Still with some showers, but the most persistent rain restricted to northern and eastern parts of Scotland by then. Pretty cold feel here, with the wind coming down from the north no higher than 12 or 13. At best in the sunshine, in parts of the south, 18 or 19, perhaps the odd 20, that's 68 Fahrenheit. Here's a summary.
Power, Jim. Power, whatever the weather.
Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz?
My friends all drive Porsches, I must make amends. Work hard,
oh my left hand,
no help from my friends. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz?
That's it.
Everything you've always wanted to know about, but we're afraid to ask.
We begin the test in 5 seconds.
Lace bras.
That feels terrific.
Satin bras.
I'm a sex goddess.
You're probably wondering,
don't squeeze them,
why your mother
lift them
recommends Pretty Poly bras.
You know, doctor, Pretty Poly bras are...
It's the way they make you feel.
It was a bus home on a rainy night when I first had a Treble Extra Strong Mint. Immediately I felt an intense burning. I was being cleansed from within. I had just felt the power of a Treble Extra Strong Mint! My life has been changed forever. Thank you, Treble!
Minty yearning, intense burning.
Don't let hay fever threaten your summer. Take Claritin Allergy. It works fast and can relieve all your hay fever symptoms without making you drowsy. So you can get on with your life.
The day's news here in the capital in just a moment with London Tonight, presented by Katie Haswell.
Now a party election broadcast by the Green Party.
with respect to our health, our environment, our communities, and our resources. We've prepared a free information pack that explains what we all can do to help. Call us now on free phone 0800 028 2800. And on June the 10th, vote Green Party in the European elections.
That was a party election broadcast by the Green Party.
Ready for some hocus pocus?
There are no camera tricks in this or any other of tonight's illusions.
The most controversial face in magic reveals the tricks of the trade.
Who is he?
And for the very first time, his true identity.
This is not a trick.
Breaking the Magician's Code, Saturday 6:35 on ITV.
Good evening, I'm Katie Haswell. This is London Tonight. The woman whose body was found in the grounds of the Royal Horticultural Gardens yesterday was a prostitute. A murder investigation began in April when Amanda Walker's blood-stained clothing was found, hours after police released her on bail for soliciting. A man has been charged with her murder.
Scene of crime, officers searching through undergrowth for clues after a woman's semi-naked body was discovered buried beneath a pile of rotting leaves. It happened in the grounds of the world-famous Royal Horticultural Gardens at Wisley in Surrey. Senior police officers working on the case confirmed the woman's body was badly decomposed and was found by a gardener after reports of a pungent smell coming from woodland. The garden just off the A3, close to the M25, proved to be a secluded dumping ground for hiding the body, even though it was barely concealed under a thin layer of bracken and leaves. It's rhododendron time at Wisley. Scores of visitors would have unknowingly passed close by the body, which was lying near the entrance to the garden. This rural corner of Surrey is a long way from the streets of London that Amanda Kelly Walker had chosen to ply her trade. The 21-year-old prostitute was picked up by police in the notorious red light area of Sussex Gardens in Paddington on April the 24th, the last day she was seen alive. She was taken to Harrow Road Police Station, where she was charged with soliciting and released on bail. As she left the station, she asked for directions back to Sussex Gardens, a journey that would end in her death and the discovery of blood-stained clothing in Hanworth Wood in Middlesex. Even before her body was found at Wisley, a man had been arrested and appeared in court. David Alexander Smith, a 43-year-old driver from Hampton in West London, has been charged with killing her. At Wisley Gardens in Surrey, this is Christopher Peacock for London Tonight.
Detectives are questioning two people about last Friday's double shooting in Acton Lane in Harlesden, which left one man dead and another wounded. A man and a woman were arrested in Harlesden last night. They're being held at Collingdale Police Station. It emerged today that a couple's decision to take a half-term holiday actually saved their lives. Lightning struck June and David Ashfield's house during last night's storm. Luckily, the couple from Ealing had taken their children away for a break.
Daylight shines through the roof where the lightning struck, setting the top of the house on fire and causing extensive damage to what was a family home. But despite the destruction and the mess, David Ashforth, his wife and two young children are counting their blessings, thankful that when nature did its worst, they survived. The family were 75 miles away, enjoying a half-term holiday in the Cotswolds when lightning struck their home back in Ealing. They learned the news in a phone call from a neighbour in the middle of the night.
It would have hit us in bed, because that's exactly where we sleep. So the fire officer said that we wouldn't have been around any longer if we'd been sleeping there.
You'd have been killed?
That's right.
This is where the Ashforths would have been sleeping had they been at home.
We just heard a big noise, big crash, woke us up obviously, their house alarm had gone off, and we just could smell the smoke and we rushed out, called the fire brigade first and we just rushed out.
Well, I think it hit the roof and it made a big hole, and then it did a really big fire at the top of the roof, and they did the hose and it went through the ceiling and started flooding.
Laura's brother Stuart is celebrating his fourth birthday today, but seemed unperturbed by all the fuss.
he's quite pleased because A, he's opening his presents, and B, he was had his photograph taken with a fireman, so he's quite pleased about that.
His parents, though, are left counting the cost of last night's storm, with the upheaval of moving out of their fire-ravaged house until workmen can turn it back into a home. In South Ealing, this is Louise Bevan for London Tonight.
An aircrew took to the skies today to try to recreate aviation history. They left Brooklands in Surrey in a replica Vickers Vimy World War I bomber on the first leg of a journey to South Africa. The first attempt in 1920 ended in failure, and bad weather forced today's adventurers to land prematurely in Farnborough. They'll continue their journey tomorrow. And actually, Brooklands is the venue for a special edition of London Tonight tomorrow. The Surrey landmark was the birthplace of British motor racing and aviation. And Alastair Stewart will be looking at the past, present and future of the historic track. We'll also be revealing what was lurking deep in Loch Ness and meeting the men who have brought a war hero back to life. And we'll be talking not to one, but to two round-the-world record breakers. Plus, one of the men who's given McLaren the winning formula in the Grand Prix racing. That's London Tonight on the road from Brooklands in Surrey tomorrow at 6. But from us for the moment, it's good night. Bye-bye.
Weather is sponsored by Amarada, the energy company.
Good evening. If you're thinking it's about time the weather settled down, think again. There are more showers to come. One or two quite heavy ones tonight, but in between, some drier spells and quite a warm one. Temperatures no lower than 12 Celsius anywhere. A fairly sticky 14 in the middle of town, 57 Fahrenheit. Tomorrow morning, starting off rather grey yet again. Periods of rain, some of those quite heavy, although hopefully nothing as heavy as we saw this morning. That damp weather lasting into the afternoon in a few places, but then later on, hopefully things brightening up a touch from the west, some sunshine to end the day, but showers never far away. Temperature-wise, 17 or 18, perhaps the odd 19 in the sunshine, and still that blustery southwesterly wind. I'm afraid the outlook holds no promise of things settling down, more showers to come, and turning a touch cooler.
For a more detailed five-day outlook, call Weather Update, sponsored by Amarada.
We thought it would be useful to tell you about digital TV in a calm and orderly manner. Fact, digital TV through an aerial is awfully easy to install. You can either get a new digital television set or simply plug a set-top box into your existing television set. That is, your existing television set. Either way, take it home and plug it in. So, pop along to your television shop and ask them about digital TV through an aerial.
If he's wrong now...
I didn't kill him.
Could he pay the ultimate price?
Am I gonna die?
Robson Green, Touching Evil, Sunday at 9.
Not just on the wrong side of the law, but on the wrong side of the mob too. Patrick Dempsey stars in Run, next.
Here you go, Chris.
You don't want to leave that there, Tony. I'll only nick it.
No, it's yours, mate.
Come on, Tony, it's me. You can't trust me with anything.
No, Chris, you don't understand. It's your holster.
No, you don't understand, son. I'm a geezer, aren't I? I'm Larry. I'm a little bit woo, a little bit wee, a little bit... I'll nick anything.
Suit yourself.
You're very lucky there, mate. I nearly had that away.
Do I look like thunder thighs?
You look gorgeous.
I think it's a bit too flouncy.
No, it's lovely.
It kind of goes well with my tan, though, doesn't it, the colour?
Yeah, great.
Do you think I look a bit tarty?
Yep, wear it.
No, I'd be yanking it down all the time. I'll just try one more thing on.
Whatever you wear, try one of Soft and Gentle's stylish new fragrances. Soft Jasmine and Cool Breeze, new from Soft and Gentle.
You can phone to get a goldfish that helps all around the home. But we travelled to a pet shop for one that doesn't.
Hello.
there's something really tasty. Whiskers Singles. Gently cooked and foil packed for freshness. Keeps all the goodness and flavour locked in. So there's no tastier meat around. Mmm, meat. Whiskers Singles. A fresh and different meal every time.
The show where records are broken. From the bizarre to the daredevils who defeat danger. Incredible feats of human achievement. Guinness World Records. Friday at 9, ITV.
Would you be willing to trade all the days for one chance to tell our enemies that they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom?
Can I think about it?
Toyota, sponsors of the ITV movie premiere.
Get away, Green! I did it!
Come on, Cole, check back!
One for me, one for you, one for me,
Cod Door,
and another one for you.
A taste so generous it just has to be shared. So, why wait? Cod Door, from Walls, made for sharing.
Video Sports Shower Gel wasn't only developed by people in white coats,
but with people in white shorts.
Over 1,000 of us who know.
Training takes a lot out of you.
From sweaty, muddy, dirty and tired.
Physio Sports Shower Gel with arginine sorts you out, leaving you with healthier feeling hair and skin.
So you look good and feel good.
Good enough to go out training all over again.
New Physiosport Clean. Developed for you by 1,000 top athletes.
So, you use Persil Non-Bio tablets?
Yeah, that's right.
Is that because you're concerned about the little ones' delicate skin?
Yeah. And the big ones.
Persil Non-Bio. Are you the sensitive type?
Tomorrow, House of Fraser are taking millions of pounds off thousands of items in fashion, homewares, electricals, and furniture. But only for one day. So if you don't go tomorrow, you'll miss it. The House of Fraser One Day Spectacular. Tomorrow from 8 till late.
This is Street Vibes 3, the definitive R&B street soul album. Street Vibes 3.
Where can you find a car that is not only cool on the outside, but with air conditioning at no extra cost, will also keep you cool on the inside? The Ford Car Spring Summer Collection, £8,595 on the road. Where? At your nearest Southeast Ford dealer.
You've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Take your taste buds on a culinary journey. After the program, discover the authentic taste of India right here in Britain. Our specialities include the lamb McSpicy for £1.39, the McChicken Korma Naan, vegetable samosa, and pineapple sundae. All served by our friendly staff and all just minutes from this screen. So, for curry in a hurry, pop a dom to
McDonald's restaurant just around the corner. Eat in or take away.
This is the new Vauxhall Zafira. Unlike some family cars, it doesn't just have 5 seats, it has 7. And yet, there's still more head and leg room than with some big cars. Thanks to Flex 7 technology, you can remove the seats without actually removing them, like this and like this. So, here we have 1,700 litres of space. That's much, much more than in some estate cars. Of course, being bigger on the inside, on the outside, it has to be that little bit bigger than some big cars. And this one is... well, no, that can't be right, though, can it? Well, because it's smaller. It's a lot smaller. No, I don't understand.
Vauxhall, raising the standard.
Perché você não fica para tomar o último pedido?
Ah, que bom. Então você pode me ajudar com esse muro?
He who drinks Australian, thinks Australian.
If your skin feels like it's suffocating with dirt, makeup, and pollution, release your pores with oxygen. The new cleansing range that feels like it's breathing life into your skin. New oxygen. Breathe life into your skin.
Let hay fever threaten your summer. Take Claritin Allergy. It works fast and can relieve all your hay fever symptoms without making you drowsy. So you can get on with your life.
Carry the big fresh flavor wherever you go.
Wrigley's has always had the biggest, freshest flavor.
The big fresh flavor.
Tomorrow, House of Fraser are taking millions of pounds off thousands of items in fashion, homewares, electricals, and furniture, but only for one day. So if you don't go tomorrow, you'll miss it. The House of Fraser One Day Spectacular. Tomorrow from 8 till late.
Good morning, Vietnam!
Don't move. He can't see us if we don't move.
Toyota, sponsors of the ITV movie premiere.
One evil.
This man kills for pleasure.
One target.
Let his death be a declaration immediately.
ITV's 007 brings you the second Bond movie.
Things are shaping up nicely.
And the first to feature a very old friend.
Now watch very carefully.
Starring Sean Connery with Desmond Llewellyn in his first appearance as Q from Russia with Love, 8:30 next Wednesday.
Next tonight, the latest ITV news from the studios of ITN.
Late at night. Can't sleep. Feels like you're the only one. Relax. At times it happens to one in three of us. But millions of people trust Nitol to gently help them fall into a natural sleep. Isn't it time you joined them? You can rise and shine after a good Nitol.
New easy-to-swallow Windy's gel caps can take care of painful bloating and trapped wind with no hanging around. Angus?
New liquid-filled Settlers Windy's gel caps bring express relief.
Angus?
I'm wearing very special lenses. They're called reactions because they react to light. So I only need one pair of spectacles for all these conditions. But don't take my word for it. At Specsavers opticians, when you buy complete price spectacles from their £69 range or above, you'll get Specsavers reaction lenses fitted free of charge, so you can try them yourself.
Are you up yet, Rob?
I love my bed, and I hate getting out of it, which is why I need all the help I can get to wake up.
Crispy Kellogg's cornflakes with a splash of ice-cold milk. Yes! I don't know where I'd be without my mum and a bowl of cornflakes. Yeah, I do. In bed.
Fragrance with the feel of a warm summer's afternoon. Summer Breeze, captured for the Lenore World Scents Collection.
I hear Goldfish can get you vouchers for Asda, Boots and Marks and Spencer.
You can't tip me, 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 you can't tip me.
Love is like candy on a shelf. You want a taste and to help yourself, just help yourself to my lips, to my arm, just say the word, they are yours. Just help yourself to the love in my heart, your smile has opened up the door.
Walls Cornetto, it's a love man.
He's going in, I can't follow him.
What's on your clothes, the lady?
I haven't done my legs.
Towel?
And the moisturising cream?
This is better.
New Imac Hair Removal Cream.
They've added softening oils.
Mmm, smooth and moisturized.
We do our best for our people.
Imac, mission impeccable. And now there's new Imac Sensitive Plus, a new generation of high-performance creams that target hair and respect your skin. Imac, mission impeccable.
Robert Kingsford. As a consultant, he fears nothing.
Robert Kingsford. As a man, he fears his future.
Christine Fletcher. A doctor whose career is breaking new ground.
Christine Fletcher. A woman whose marriage is breaking her heart. Niamh Cusack. Martin Shaw. Always and everyone. Monday at 9, ITV.
David Scobie. A doctor who is single-minded.
David Scobie. A man who is single.
You're watching ITV now, the latest national and international news.
A first meeting is taking place in Belgrade between President Milosevic and the EU and Russian envoys. The Yugoslav side said it wanted to think about the terms they presented and talk again today. The Russian envoy, Viktor Chernomyrdin, said it was a difficult choice for the Yugoslav leadership, but the choice had to be made. Up to 9 people have been reported killed after an American Airlines Super 80 airliner crashed as it landed in a thunderstorm at Little Rock, Arkansas. The plane skidded on the runway, broke up and burst into flames. Officials said it was a miracle more didn't die. Missing schoolgirl Vicky Lambert has been found safe and well in Cleethorpes. The 14-year-old from Scunthorpe disappeared from home on Friday morning and was believed to have run off with a neighbour, 30-year-old factory worker Chris Langan. Police say she seems in good health. A massive rescue operation was mounted last night after 77 boats competing in a national yachting regatta off Weymouth in Dorset were capsized by a squall. 154 people were thrown into the sea, but all are safe. Aston Villa's Australian goalkeeper Mark Bosnich has signed for Manchester United, where he started his British career 10 years ago. He's agreed a 4-year contract thought to be worth £1 million a year. And 2 winning lottery tickets shared the £3.8 million jackpot in last night's national lottery draw. The winning numbers were 17, 23, 27, 34, 36 and 37. The bonus ball was 12. Well, that's it for now. I'll be back with more news later.
In just a moment, our film Wired tells the story of the turbulent life of comedian John Belushi. But first, we're off on the night shift.
Hi, we're on a night shift. You can see it's 4 o'clock in the morning. It's not cold at all. We've come to meet these guys who are on the night shift too. Can you see that? Let's see what we've got in here. Hi, fellas. Can we come and talk to you?
Morning, by all means.
Very good. This is our crew. We're talking to guys working at night. Who are you?
Fine. Tony,
yeah.
I'm 80.
Fine, nice to meet you. So, is this it? This 4 o'clock, at 4:30 in the morning, you just sit here playing cards? I suppose this is not a busy time, is it, really?
Especially in the early part of the week.
Yeah, when is your busiest time through the clock, you know? 2 o'clock in the morning, 12 o'clock?
Of a weekend?
Yeah.
When we're talking about in the early morning? Between midnight and 3.
Right.
But otherwise...
Well, no one wants a cab at 4:30 in the morning, I suppose, do they?
Not many.
Is there someone trying to get through to you on the radio? Who is it?
36 Gaggedale.
Thank you.
What's he want? How can you understand?
I just know that he's picked up.
Right. Alright, so he's taking his fare to the destination now, he's on his way there. But I can never understand what these guys are saying on these machines. How do you get your ear tuned into it or something?
You do, because occasionally you get the passengers saying to you, how on earth do you understand what the operator is saying to you in the car?
Yeah.
But you just learn it.
It's like another language, really, like learning Italian, isn't it?
Yeah.
Tell me how does it work exactly, the fact that, like, today you've got maybe two or three drivers on at this time in the morning, but sometimes on your peak times you've got 20. Do they work for you? Do you actually employ them? How does it work? How does the money work?
When you're a taxi driver, you work for yourself, excuse me, but you are self-employed, but it's the most peculiar situation. But I employ them. They pay dues every week, which entitles them to the use of the radio.
Right.
And I can take them on and I can get rid of them.
Right.
But they in fact, work for themselves.
Right. So, in fact, they keep the fares. They keep the fares that they're getting from their customers, and they pay you to hire the radio that gets them the work in the first place.
That's right.
I've got it. Yeah, see. Yeah, I see. And the kettle's boiled, is it?
Yeah.
Very good. We could have a cup of tea now, couldn't we?
We can indeed.
Oh, that'd be a good idea, wouldn't it? Would we fancy a cup of tea, do we?
Yeah.
Very good. Well, we'll have a cup of tea now, if you've got enough cups. Come on, let's see the next one, then. 10. Yeah. Oh, no, I've got a blackjack. Red jack, I mean. Oh, there's a red jack. No, this is all going wrong. This is hopeless. I'm sorry, Tony. We can't stay with you. But anyway, we've got... see you later. We've got Regis turned up in his cab. Let's go and have a quick word with him. Don't drive away. How are you? All right?
All right, thank you.
What kind of a night have you had?
Oh, not bad.
Did you paint this white? This isn't meant to be white, is it?
No, you have to buy them white.
Oh, you buy them white?
You can't change the colour of them once you've got them.
Right, is that part of the Hackney Carriage rule?
No, it's just the firm when they make them, they say, just white is white, and that's it.
Now, these are wonderful vehicles, aren't they? They can turn on a sixpence.
Yes.
What other great features have you got on in this cab?
You've got safety.
Right.
Which you've got a glass panel between you and the passengers.
Right.
Right, so you don't have much hassle, but if you did have hassle, you must have. You've also got central locking.
Yeah, so they can't get out the cab until it becomes stationary.
That's right, yeah.
Right. How many miles has it done?
It's done quite a few. This has done 132312.
130, cool, yeah. Well, make it do another 6. I want to go home. Is that all right?
Yeah, certainly,
yeah. Very good. We'll see you next time. Cheerio.
36.
Take me home, James. Thanks very much. Go ahead, Elf. That way. Cold all night, isn't it?
This is ITV, now the high life and hard times of John Belushi in our film Wired. And this film contains strong language and scenes of drug taking.
This is the new Vauxhall Zafira. Unlike some family cars, it doesn't just have 5 seats, it has 7. And yet, there's still more head and leg room than with some big cars. Thanks to Flex 7 technology, you can remove the seats without actually removing them, like this and like this. So, here we have 1,700 litres of space. That's much, much more than in some estate cars. Of course, being bigger on the inside, on the outside, it has to be that little bit bigger than some big cars. And this one is... well, no, that can't be right, though, can it? Well, because it's smaller. It's a lot smaller. No, I don't understand.
Vauxhall, raising the standard.
Dad. He's my granddad.
Could you be doing a bit more health-wise? Like trying Kellogg's Health-Wise Bran Flakes with a balanced diet and more exercise.
That's my dad. He says he's in with a chance this year.
What? The one next to my dad?
Kellogg's Health-Wise Bran Flakes. A step in the right direction.
He's going in. I can't follow him.
Well, had your clothes in the ladies?
I haven't done my legs.
Towel?
And the moisturising cream?
This is better.
New Imac Hair Removal Cream.
They've added softening oils.
Mmm, smooth and moisturised.
We do our best for our people. Imac, mission impeccable. And now there's new Imac Sensitive Plus, a new generation of high-performance creams that target hair and respect your skin. Imac, mission impeccable.
This is Street Vibes 3. The definitive R&B Street Soul album. The only one to bring together Tatiana Ali, Shola Amma, Glamour Kid and The Honeys. Street Vibes 3. 38 killer tunes. TQ, Lauryn Hill and Blackstreet. Get the number one from Shanks and Bigfoot on Street Vibes 3. One serious double album.
This is what it takes to firm up your body. And this is what it takes to firm up your skin. Nivea Body Skin Firming Complex, your daily routine for firmer skin.
Join the party! Call 0930 18 18 18 now! That's 0930 18 18 18! Call the party now!
Take your taste buds on a culinary journey. After the program, discover the authentic taste of India right here in Britain. House specialities include the lamb McSpicy for £1.39, the McChicken Korma Naan, vegetable samosa and pineapple sundae. All served by our friendly staff and all just minutes from this screen. So, for curry in a hurry, pop a dom to McDonald's restaurant just around the corner. Eat in or take away.
The only way to stop the build of limescale in your washing machine is to use Calgon tablets in every wash.
Washing machines live longer with Calgon.
If you want a car that's tough and durable, with reinforced safety cells
and side impact protection system, try the Citroen Saxo from only $6,995 with 2 years free insurance.
And that's not all. Sound deadening.
And an acoustically engineered floor to reduce engine noise. The Citroen Saxo, available from just $6,995 with 2 years free insurance.
As dentists will tell you, although too much sugar too often can be bad for children's teeth, fruit acids in soft drinks can also damage tooth enamel. But with its substantially lower levels of fruit acids, Ribena Toothkind has been scientifically proven to minimize tooth erosion. Ribena Toothkind. Open wide and say ah.
Does your skin feel like it's being suffocated? Then release your pores with the brand new cleansing range Oxygen. Breathe life into your skin.
Yeah, I've just had it resprayed. Raging Bull Red with Super Sheen metallic finish. Nice, innit? The Dysentery Beige wasn't exactly a babe magnet. Anyway, I had to save a few bob to get it done, so I sort of forgot to pay my TV licence. And I got caught and fined. Still, the lasses don't notice in the dark. Or if I stand here, like this.
It was a bus home on a rainy night when I first had a Treble Extra Strong Mint. Immediately I felt an intense burning. I was being cleansed from within. I had just felt the power of a Treble Extra Strong Mint. My life has been changed forever. Thank you, Treble.
Minty yearning, intense burning.
Now it's so easy to help keep your teeth clean and white. Introducing new Ice White from Wrigley's. The great-tasting sugar-free chewing gum proven to reduce the stains that build up on your teeth time after time throughout the whole day. Just by chewing great-tasting Ice White, your teeth will feel cleaner and look whiter. So chew new Ice White. It's the easy way to cleaner, whiter teeth.
Can your camera take three different picture sizes whenever you want? Is your film as easy to load as this? And are your favorite pictures as easy to find as this? Kodak Advantix cameras, a great way to take pictures and share pictures. From only $39.99.
Quelque chose ne va pas?
J'ai 93 ans aujourd'hui.
C'est merveilleux.
Regardez, c'est ma femme. Elle a 25 ans. La plus belle fille du monde. Nous faisons l'amour tous les jours. Elle est parfaite.
Mais alors, vous pleurez de bonheur?
Non, je ne me souviens plus où j'habite.
At least Haagen-Dazs is 100% perfect.
So, you use Persil Non-Bio tablets?
Yeah, that's right.
Is that because you're concerned about the little one's delicate skin?
Yeah. And the big ones.
Persil Non-Bio. Are you the sensitive type?
This is Street Vibes 3. The definitive R&B Street Soul album. The only one to bring together Tatiana Ali, Shola Amma, Glamour Kid and The Honeys. Street Vibes 3. 38 killer tunes. TQ, Lauryn Hill and Blackstreet. Get the number one from Shanks and Bigfoot on Street Vibes 3. One serious double album.
Where can you find a car that is not only cool on the outside, but with air conditioning at no extra cost, will also keep you cool on the inside? The Ford Car Spring Summer Collection, £8,595 on the road. Where? At your nearest Southeast Ford dealer.